Welcome to my today class. In this class, I'm going to discuss some more problem to construction of Fourier series. Especially, I'm going to consider splitting function. Up to the previous class, we consider only functions, say f of x is equal to x square over the interval minus pi to pi, or e power of x 0 to 2 pi, like that. Instead of that, suppose they're going to give the function is in the form of splitting function. For example, in such cases, how to find out Fourier series? Suppose the function is a splitting function. Now, one of the problem is all written on the board. Find the Fourier series for the function f of x is equal to minus 1 plus x for x lies between minus pi to 0, 1 plus x for x greater than 0 less than pi. And hence, deduce that pi by 4 equals 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 7, etc. We have to do deduce what later. First, we have to construct the Fourier series for the given function. Now, the given function is actually, first I'm going to write what's a given function in the problem. Given function is a splitting function because they are given to split the functions minus pi to 0, 0 to pi. Now, that's a thing we have to observe carefully here. Now, minus 1 plus x for minus pi less than x less than 0. 1 plus x for x greater than 0 less than pi. This is our given function. Whenever the given function is a splitting function, the question is arise how to find out Fourier series. In that case, you take entire the range. What's the lower limit is minus pi. What is my upper limit is pi. Now, this is a way I have to take entire range. How to take entire range of the given splitting function? The first limit and last limit is minus pi to pi. The entire range is splitted at point 0, minus pi to 0, one function, 0 to pi is another function. Now here, first we have to take entire range. This range is equal to which form? Our second case, minus LTL. You already know that whenever the given function is defined in the form of second case, it's possible I have to get into the second step. What's the second step? It's possible I have to verify whether the given function is even or odd. Now observe carefully how to verify even or odd. Suppose the function is a splitting function. Keep in mind, splitting function first you take overall range. After that to decide you go for first case or second case. This is in the form of first case, second case. Therefore move to verify even or odd. How to verify even or odd? Carefully you have to observe this. Replace x by minus x. Whatever the x you have in each of the place, I'm going to replace it by minus x. Okay. And also 1 minus x, 0, less than minus x, less than pi. Now, if you want to verify it's an even or odd, first try to express the given limit. Actually, given limit based on x. Here, the limit is based on minus x. From the basic definition of inequality, first try to convert this limit also in the same form, in terms of x, but here in terms of minus x. What we are going to do? Now, I'm going to explain separately for that part. The part is actually minus pi less than minus x less than 0. This is also equivalent to pi greater than x greater than 0. Means once you multiplied by entire inequality, what we get? Pi change, once you multiplied negative sign, now I have to change the inequality. Pi greater than x greater than 0 means 0 less than x less than pi. Similarly, 0, now we have to change negative to positive, x. 0 less than minus pi less than x. This is also equivalent to 0 greater than 0. Yeah, I did mistake here. 1 minute. This is actually x. This is pi. Okay. Minus 0 minus x less than pi. Once you multiplied by minus sign, we change the inequality x greater than minus y. This is nothing but what actually? Minus pi less than x less than 0. I changed it in the standard form. That's all. Therefore, this can also be written as minus 1 minus x minus pi minus x minus pi less than minus x less than 0 can also be written as 0 less than x less than pi. And then 1 minus x is nothing but minus pi less than x less than 0. Now we have to verify for each of the interval. When we say that the function is even, in each of the limit, this after replacing my x by minus x, in each of the limit, what we are expecting? what you have in f of x, same thing. In both the interval, not for one interval, in both the interval, then only I have to consider it's an even function. Observe 0 to pi, here minus 1 to minus 1 minus x, but 0 to pi what we have? 1 plus x is not equal. Once is not equal to the one of the limit, not necessary to verify second limit. Then confidently I have to write this is not equal to what? It's not equal to f of x. Therefore, it's not an even function. It's not equal to f of x. Whether it's possible is an odd function. How to verify is an odd function? Just you take minus sign outside. How to take minus sign outside here? Now, I have to take minus sign from this function, also this function, minus of. Once you take minus, what we get? 1 plus x for x ranging from 0 to pi. And then once you take minus n, what happened? 1 become minus, x become plus. Okay? In the range minus pi less than x less than 0. Observe carefully here. After once you taken a minus n outside, 0 to pi 1 plus x. 0 to pi e also 1 plus x. Once you satisfies one of the interval, don't leave it. Must one should have to verify both the limits. Both the limits we get same function, then it's okay. Okay, don't take a decision based on one of the interval. Minus pi to 0, minus 1 plus x. Here also minus 1 plus x. Therefore, this shows that this after once you take a minus n, what we get actually, this must be equal to minus of f of x. I taken beginning f of minus x, finally we get f of minus of f of x. Therefore, the given function is odd function. Keep in mind, suppose the given function is a splitting function, overall range or overall interval is in the form of second case, don't find out immediately. You verify whether even or odd. How to verify? Just replace everywhere in every place of x by minus x. After that, you change this inequality. It means minus x had to change to x by using fundamental inequality concepts. And then verify, suppose equal to f of x is fine, is an even function. Suppose it's not equal to f of x, just you take minus n outside. How to take minus n? You take in both the function minus n, not for the interval. Once you take minus n, now automatically in this function becomes what f of x. Therefore, the given function is odd function. See, the given function is an odd function, not necessary to find out a, not an an. They reduce number of steps to calculation. We get same marks in spite of that. Suppose you are not verify even or odd. Just you find out a naught, an, and bn, definitely we get a naught 0, an 0. Simply are wasting your time. Therefore, carefully verify, especially for splitting function, is a overall interval is in the form of second case. This is the easiest way to verify is an even or odd. Therefore, what we are going to write here? Therefore, the given function is an odd function. Odd function, and what are the values of 0? A naught and an is 0, you already know that. Now, especially for a splitting function, we get is even or odd, then easy to calculate. Not necessary to take entire range. It is enough to take either minus pi to 0 or 0 to pi. The corresponding Fourier series for f of x over the interval, what's the interval? Minus pi to plus pi is. Before going to construct the Fourier series, first you have to know what are the values of L and N pi x by L. What's my interval? Minus L to L. What's the given interval? Minus pi to pi. Equate that. We get immediately what's the value of L. Upper limit is pi. Now what is N pi x by L? Once you substitute the value of L, pi pi cancel, what we get actually? Nx. Okay? Next, I have to write what is my Fourier series. The Fourier series for this is f of x is equal to summation n ranging from 1 to infinity bn sine nx. Keep in mind, you must and should have to write these steps before going to write a0 and an is 0. Must and should have to write the verification part. Otherwise, you are going to lose the marks. Bn equals 2 by pi 0 to pi f of x into sine nx. I told very clearly how to write with respect to x, bn formula. instead of bn, what we are going to take? F of x. Now, it's not necessary to take entire range. It is enough to evaluate the bn value only the range 0 to pi. Okay. Now, bn equals 2 by pi. Okay. Now, 0 to pi. Now, you have minus pi to 0 and 0 to pi. 0 to pi, what's the function you have? 1 plus x. Therefore, now I have to substitute 0 to pi. The function is 1 plus pi. Suppose you are consider minus pi to 0, you have to take minus 1 plus x. 1 plus x into second function, sine of nx. After you have to evaluate this integral, observe carefully which one is an which one is first u function, which one is an v function. This is u because after the first derivative is 0. This is v because after the first derivative is not equal to 0. Trigonometric functions goes up to till nth derivative. Therefore, now from the UV rule or Bernoulli's rule, this is nothing but 2 by pi. First function u into integration of v. What is integration of sine? Minus cos of nx by quotient of x is n. Minus, what is differentiation of 1 plus x is 1. Again, I to integrate. Keep, while doing integration, keep the constant 1 minus 1 by n. What is integration of sine nx is, cos nx is sine nx by n. Again, the quotient of x is n square. Not necessary to move for the further steps because it's constant. I told number of times, Bernoulli's rule, we are going to stop where whenever we get derivative values must be a constant, 0 to pi. And also I told one of the point, you already familiar with that, whenever having product of one of the functions sine or cos, first we have to verify what happened, the corresponding upper and lower limit. Cos of n pi, what is cos n pi is minus 1 to the power of n. What is cos 0 is 1. Sine of n pi, what is my sine n pi value? 0. What is my sine 0 value is 0. Okay. Then this shows that this function not necessary to apply the limit because the sine nx is 0 corresponding both upper and lower limit. Only we are going to consider this one. Which one? First up, 2 by pi into n is a constant. Apply the upper limit. What is upper limit? 1 plus pi. I have to keep the minus sign also outside because we have a negative sign here. Now, while now I have to keep the negative sign outside also, minus 2 by pi n is constant, keep it outside. 1 plus pi into cos n pi. What is cos n pi? Is minus 1 to the power of n. Minus cos 0. What is cos 0 is 1. X is equal to 0. What we get? 1 plus 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1. Therefore, better I have to take minus n inside the bracket. What we get? 2 by, which we get very easily for this value, bn value, 2 by pi n of, take minus n inside the bracket, the 1 become plus, minus of 1 plus pi into minus 1 to the power of n. Yes. Okay, fine. This is my what actually bn. Now, before moving to the next step, I told number of times, first you have to verify whether bn is 0 for any value for ranging from 1 to infinity. How can you know that? For which value of n, bn becomes infinity. Once you get the value of n, pick the denominator n quantity. What you have in the denominator n is n. N is equal to 0, then only we get 0 in the denominator. Once we get 0 in the denominator, then only we are expecting infinity. But our summation is start from what? 1 to infinity. Therefore, confidently I have to write this is true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. This is a way to, no need to verify a1, a2, a3. Once we get n or bn, pick the denominator quantity of n. What are the terms you have? Equal to 0, solve that. Verify whether that value is included or not. N is equal to 0 is not included. Therefore, confidently say that is true for all the values we get finite value. Now, after that, we have to construct the Fourier series. Now, Fourier series for this function is f of x equals n summation. While writing summation, better to keep the constant 2 by pi is a constant outside. Summation in ranging from 1 to infinity, 1 by n of 1 minus half 1 plus pi into minus 1 to the power of n. into sine of nx. This is nothing but is the required, this is the easiest way to find out Fourier series, even though the given function is a splitting function, required Fourier series for the given function over the interval minus pi comma plus pi. Okay, fine. Now I want to deduce some result. What's the result I want to deduce here? The result is pi by 4. Yeah, I'm going to write because we have to familiar with that. Then only I have to carefully I have to compare with. We are going to choose the value. Yeah, what is deduce part we want? Pi by 4 equals pi by 4 is equal to 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5. Minus 1 by 4 plus etc. This is my required deduce part. I told number of times we don't have any particular method to deduce that. Just you compare with construction of Fourier series to the deduce part. In the deduce part, 1 can also be written as 1 by 1, minus 1 by 3, plus 1 by 5, minus 1 by 4. This shows that we want only a odd number. Yeah, we have 1 by 1, put n is equal to 1, we get 1 by 1, put n is equal to 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, like that. Only are expecting a odd value, 1 by 1, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 7. This is not 4 actually, this is 7. This is 7 actually. After 5, you don't get it lesser value, you get higher value, 1 by 7, etc. Now here, I want to find out this is series. Observe carefully, if you want to retain odd value of 1 by n, now odd value of 1 by n I want. Now I don't want even. Therefore, you know that what's our range? Minus pi to pi. Suppose put x is equal to pi by 2. I don't want sine. I don't want sine. You observe here. Here we don't have sine. Now I want to eliminate, but I required only an odd value. This shows that suppose I put x is equal to pi by 2, you already know that how to define sine of n pi by 2. What is sine of n pi by 2 is already explained my in second, third class of my video. Sine n pi by 2 is a plus or minus 1 if n is odd. If n is odd. 0 if n is even. 0 if n is even. Now I think this is clear how we get this step. This is a one of our thing. This shows that plus or minus 1. Anyway, we require plus minus sign, odd value. Therefore, why don't you go for x is equal to pi by 2. Pi by 2 also is in the range minus pi to plus pi. Therefore, what we are going to do here, just we are going to put x is equal to pi. This is a way to compare to choose the value of x. Put x is equal to pi by 2 in the above expression. In the above expression, we get what we get actually. In the above expression, once you put the value for x is equal to pi by 2, we have to put both left hand side and right hand side. F of pi by 2 must be equal to 2 by pi summation n ranging from 1 to infinity. Okay. Now, I have to put the value of sine is n is what actually x is pi by 2, 1 plus pi into minus 1 to the power of n of sine of n pi by 2. Once you put the sine of n pi by 2, once you put the value of x, we have to know very carefully. You already know that sine of n pi by 2 is not equal to plus or minus 1, only the case for n is equal to 1, odd cases. Therefore, not necessary to take 1 to infinity. See, product of one of the function is 0, definitely this flower bracket, product of flower bracket into sine of n pi by 2 for even case must be 0. Therefore, what I am going to mention here, n is equal to 1, 3, 5, etc. Not necessary to take 1 to 2, 1 to infinity, because only sine of n pi by 2 we get plus or minus 1 if n is odd. Therefore, no need I to take 2, 4 value. Then I have to expand this. Before going to expand that, I want to find out my f of x. What is my f of x? Is f of x is actually 1 plus x for 0 to pi minus 1 plus x for minus pi to 0. You already know that. Yeah. Now, pi by 2 is in which range? This range. Therefore, in this range, what is my function? 1 plus x. Just you put x is equal to pi by 2. Take LCM and simplify that. What we get? 2 plus pi divided by 2. Okay. In the next step, now I'm going to substitute the value of f of pi by 2. Don't confuse. Pi by 2 in the range 0 to pi. Therefore, I'm going to choose this function. Put x is equal to pi by 2. To after taken LCM, 2 plus pi divided by 2 we get. And then 2 by pi. Yeah. Now, only the odd cases, first I have to observe what happened in odd case, this flower bracket. That is also, I'm going to do it in the way in one of the side. Observe carefully, this is a flower bracket, 1 minus of 1 plus pi into minus 1 to the power of n. What happened? N is equal to 1, 3, etc. Put for n is equal to 1, what happened? For n is equal to 1, 1 minus of 1 plus pi minus 1. Minus of minus plus, what we get? 2 plus pi. Minus of minus plus, 1 plus 1 is 2 plus pi. Suppose put n is equal to 3, what we get actually? 1 minus of 1 plus pi. What is minus 1 whole cube is minus. Minus into minus plus, 1 plus 1 is 2, we get 2 pi. This shows 2 plus pi. This shows that for n is equal to r, whatever this flower bracket value is 2 plus pi. Therefore, we are confidently have to choose for whenever n is equal to r cases, what we get actually 2 plus pi. 2 plus pi in by 1 into sine of pi by 2. Okay. And then plus r case 2 plus pi divided by 3 sine of 3 pi by 2. Okay. And next r case 2 plus pi again flower bracket divided by 5 sine of 5 pi by 2 plus 2 plus pi divided by 7 sine of 7 pi by 7 pi by 2 etc. Okay. Now I to what's a common factor here? Common factor is 2 plus pi. Okay, in the next step, 2 plus pi divided by 2 equals 2 into 2 plus pi is a common factor by pi. Sine pi by 2, what is sine pi by 2 is 1. 1 by 1 is 1. Sine 3 pi by 2 is minus 1 by 3. Sine pi by 2 is sine of 5 into pi by 2 is 1. We get 1 plus 1 by 5. Sine of 7 pi by 2 is minus. We get 1 by 7, etc. Okay. Now observe carefully here, 2 plus pi is cancelled. Take cross multiplication for this. This implies what we get, pi divided by 2 into 2 is 4, is equal to 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 7, etc. This is where to require deduce part. This is the easiest way to find out deduce part. Now before moving to the next problem, I want just quick glance for this problem because it's a splitting function. The question arises, the given function, suppose it's a splitting function, how to proceed? First, you take overall range of the given interval. What is my overall range is minus pi to pi. Once you, this is minus pi to pi, as usual, it's referred to the second case. Then we have another step into that, go for even or odd. What I did, I had to replace x by minus x. How to replace? Instead, where we have x in the splitting function, everywhere I had to replace it by minus x. But if you want to verify whether it's equal to f of x or minus f of x, suppose you convert after replace x by minus x, the interval, here you're having based on minus x, you change it to plus x using basic concept of inequality. After you convert that, you verify it. In the first interval itself is not satisfied. No need I to verify the second one. Therefore, it's not equal to f of x. Now, what I did after that, I taken minus sign outside. How to take minus 1? I take minus 1 for the first interval of the function, second interval of the function. After that, what happened? That must be equal to f of x. Therefore, now I'm going to write the given function is an odd function. In the confidently, I have to write a0, an is 0. And the corresponding Fourier series is based on vn only. Simultaneously, I have to find out the value of what actually n pi x pi l value. Simultaneously, I want to find out the value of sine pi x pi l also. Now here we get actually, once you put the value of this one, what we get actually nx, okay, nx, pi pi cancel, we get nx. Now I have to substitute that carefully, I have to evaluate by using Bernoulli's rule, apply the upper and lower limit. This is our required Fourier series. After that, I want to deduce this, you compare that, only I have to retain odd, I don't want even, therefore I am going to, because here having sine function, therefore I am going to choose sine pi by 2 value. Sine pi by 2, you know that plus or minus 1 if n is odd, 0 if n is even. Automatically after the simplification, we get the required result. While doing simplification, I did this what about flower bracket value separately for n is equal to 1, 2, 3. For n is equal to 1, 2, 3, we get actually 2 plus pi. Now both 2 plus pi is cancelled. Automatically we get the required result. This is a way to prove. Suppose the simple way, easiest way to prove, suppose the given function is a splitting function. I move to the next, another splitting function. These are the problem, actually it's a very standard, very important problems. Okay, next problem is, second problem is obtain Fourier series for the function f of x is given by f of x equals 1 plus 2 by pi into x minus pi to 0, less than or equal to 0, and also 1 minus 2 by pi into x 0 to pi, and hence deduce that pi square by 8 equals 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square, etc. Now, first we are going to write the solution for this. I told number of times, first you write the given function. What is my given function is 1 plus, this is our given. Okay. 1 plus 2 by pi into x minus pi to 0, and then 1 minus 2 by pi into x 0 to pi. Okay, fine. Now here, what is my overall interval? What is the lower limit is minus pi. What is the upper limit of this? That is the overall interval. This is a way I have to take overall interval. This overall interval is in the form of second case. Therefore, it's possible I go for even or odd. Then just few minutes before I explain how to verify even or odd, just try to replace x by minus x. What we get, f of minus x is nothing but 1 minus of 2 by pi into x in the range minus pi less than or equal to x. Keep in mind this is a closed interval because less than or equal they given. Less than or equal, less than or equal. Therefore included both in the closed interval minus pi to plus pi. Now minus x less than or equal to 0, 1 minus x, replace it by minus, we get plus 2 by pi into x, 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi, minus x, just try to replace x by minus x. Now I have to change this inequality, because here inequality based on x, here based on minus x. Therefore what we are going to do, minus I'm going to choose this minus pi less than or equal to minus x less than or equal to 0. Just you multiply this inequality, what we get? Actually, pi greater than x greater than 0. This is equivalent to 0 less than x less than pi. Now similarly, 0 less than equal to minus x less than equal to pi. That can also be written as 1, so multiplied minus sign 0 greater than equal to x greater than equal to minus pi. This is equivalent to what? 0 less than equal to, this is equivalent to minus pi, minus pi less than equal to x less than equal to 0. Therefore, now after that we have to verify, first we have to write it in that form. What we get actually, 1 minus 2 by pi into x in the range, what's the range? 0 less than equal to, this is less than equal to, no, equality is there, less than equal to x less than equal to pi. This is 1 plus 2 by pi into x or pi less than equal to minus pi, you observe carefully, minus pi less than equal to x less than equal to 0. Now you compare it. The given is minus pi to 0, 1 plus 2 by x. 1 plus 2 by pi into x power minus pi to 0. Don't take addition to verify the second interval. 0 to pi, 1 minus 2 pi pi. 2 by pi into x. Now we get same function, therefore what we are saying that the given function is an even function. The given function is an even function, what are the values of 0? Only one value, bn is 0. Okay, now we have to write the given function function is an even function over the interval minus pi to plus pi, and which value 0 for even function? Bn is 0 and bn is equal to 0. The corresponding Fourier series for f of x over what's the interval minus pi comma plus pi is what actually minus pi to plus pi is f of x equals a naught pi 2 plus summation in ranging from 1 to infinity an. Before moving to the next step, first I have to know what's the value of n. What's our limit is equivalent to the second case, minus pi to plus pi. That implies what is my l is pi, upper equal to the upper limit. Therefore, n pi x by l is nothing but what? N pi x by pi is cancelled, we get nx. Cos of nx, where what is a naught formula? 2 by L. What is 2 by L? Is 2 by pi. 0 to L is 0 to pi. F of x dx. What is an formula? An formula is nothing but 2 by pi. 0 to pi f of x cos nx with respect to x. Then I have to find out a naught. Now 2 by pi. 0 to pi I want to find out. You know what is my given function. What is my given function is for 0 to pi, 1 minus 2 by pi into x. Therefore, in both the cases, we have to take only, it is enough to find out half of the range that gives the Fourier series expansion of entire range for 0, minus pi to plus pi. That's the beauty of this. Suppose the function is even or odd, the given function is a splitting function. What is f of x in 0 to 2 pi? 2 by 0 to pi, 0, 1 minus 2 by pi into x with respect to x. Now I have to integrate. What is integration of 1? X minus 2 by pi into what is integration of x square by 2? What's the limit? 0 to pi. In the next step, 2 by pi. While go for the next step, observe this 2 is cancelled. Now, what's the upper limit? Pi, lower limit is 0. Minus 1 by pi, what's the upper limit? Is pi square minus 0. Now I have to simplify this. Now what happened? Now observe carefully, this is nothing but 2 by pi, pi, this 1 pi, this pi square is cancelled with pi. What's the remaining? The remaining is my pi. We have minus and minus pi. These two are cancelled. Yeah. Then we get 0. A naught is 0. Next move to an. What is my an? 2 by pi. 0 to pi. What's the function you have? 1 minus 2 by pi into x sine of nx with respect to x. Sine of nx. I go for UV rule or Bernoulli's rule. Which function is u function? Which function is v function? Which one is u function? This is my u function. This is my v function. Because after the first derivative, 1 minus 2 by pi into x is 0. Therefore, I choose this as u, the remaining as v. From the UV rule or Bernoulli's rule, 2 by pi of 1 minus 2 by pi into x. What is integration of sine minus cos nx divided by n? Because quotient of x is n minus. What is differentiation of constant is 0? Minus 2 by pi into differentiation of x is 1. Minus 1 by n is constant. What is integration of cos? Sine nx by n into n is n square. What's my limit? Now, not necessary to move for the next term because we already get a constant. What about derivative of next derivative of constant is 0. Therefore, further higher terms are 0. Therefore, what's the limit? 0 to pi. Therefore, what we get actually 2 by pi. Now, I took, while applying the limit, better I have to keep the constant 1 by n. I told number of times before moving to the next step, either having a product of sine or cos, first you verify what happened in the corresponding limit. Sine of n pi, what happens sine n pi is 0. What is sine 0? 0. But you have a cos function. What is cos n pi value is minus 1 to the power of n. What is cos 0 is 1. Okay. In the next step, I have to go for the limit. Upper limit. Once you go for the upper limit, before going to move the upper limit, observe carefully which one is 0. Here sine functions are 0. I did a mistake here. Sorry. What is the function? The function is actually here what I taken sine. Actually is cos. Please give me a excuse for this. Again, I'm going to do it once again. Yeah. Yes. Now, this is function is actually what? This function is not sine, it is cos. This is actually cos nx with respect to x. Yeah, I'm going to do it once again. Don't worry about that because now here, what's the function I have? An is cos nx, 1 minus 2 by pi into x cos nx. I go for UV rule. Once you go for UV rule, 1 minus 2 by pi into x into integration of cos. What is integration of cos? Sine nx by n minus. What is the differentiation of this is 0 minus 2 by pi into differentiation of x with respect to x 1. Again, I have to integrate. What is integration of sine is? Sine is minus cos nx by n into n is n square. Not necessary to move further step because this is constant. What is? What about the higher term is? That must be equal to 0. Don't worried about this actually. What we get actually here, minus 2 by pi into 1. Okay. Now, what's the limit is 0 to pi. Now, it's all written what is sin n pi, cos n pi. Please give me excuse if wrongly I have taken cos nx instead of that sin nx. That's why I'm explaining once again. While applying the upper and lower limit, observe carefully sin n pi 0, sin 0, 0. The product must be 0. What happened? The entire this, which one? If you want to put this as a small bracket, yeah, the entire thing, this must be equal to what happened? 0. Entire this flower bracket becomes 0 because this sin n pi is 0, sin 0 is 0. What we are going to write here, this flower bracket must be 0. Only I have to take this minus into minus plus, and then plus into minus is minus, okay? Now we get minus. So please try to understand, minus into minus plus into minus is minus 2 minus what actually? 2 by pi n square is a constant. Keep outside, apply the upper limit. What's my upper limit? Cos n pi. What is cos n pi? Is minus 1 to the power of n. Cos 0 is 1. Now it's nothing but observe carefully what we get actually. Actually, this is 2 by pi, 2 by pi. What we get actually, 2 into 2 is 4. 4 by pi square. Once you take minus sign inside the bracket, what we get actually? 1 minus of minus 1 to the power of n. Okay? Now this is my an. Yeah. First I explained based on sign. It's wrong actually. An already written cos nx. Therefore I am changed cos nx. And then again I do u applying uv rule. This is first function. This is second function. I think it's clear. I move to the next thing. The next thing is what? Before move to the next step, I told number of times that to verify whether is n is true for all values for n ranging from 1 to infinity. How to verify? Once we get an value, pick the denominator n quantity. What is the n quantity? It's n square equal to 0. In which case is 0? N is equal to 0. But our summation start from 1 to infinity. Therefore, confidently I have to write this is true for n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. Now, in one of my video, one of the problem, I explained this part. Whenever inside the flower bracket, one of the term is 1, another term is minus 1 to the power of n, even case, some cases, maybe even cases are 0, and some of the cases, odd cases are 0. Therefore, before moving to the next step, first I'm going to simplify this. Which one? Minus 1 minus of minus 1 to the power of n. This part I explained very clearly in my previous classes. Whenever this is happen, whenever one of the term is 1, another term is minus 1 to the power of n. Either maybe this minus n is interchange. Now once you put n is equal to 1, observe carefully. 1 is equal to 1. What happened? Minus into minus plus. What we get? 2. Put n is equal to 2 minus 1 whole square. Plus 1 minus 1 is 0. Even cases are 0. Odd cases, what we get? 2. Therefore, 2 if n is odd. 0 if n is even. If n is even. Therefore, what we are going to do here? Now, this can also be, this an can also be written as only the two cases. In the odd cases, what we get? 2, the entire this flower bracket. 4 2s are 8. 8 pi, pi square, n square. We get very simple form. If n is odd. Okay. 0, this flower bracket 0, entire product must be 0. 0 if n is even. If n is even. Okay, thank you. In the next step, we are going to substitute a naught and an value. But you already know that an is 0. Now, only we are going to substitute an value. While substituting an value, only we are going to consider odd cases. Why? Even cases are 0. Therefore, while substituting the odd cases value for n is equal to 1, 3, etc., first you have to mention first two odd values that shows that only we consider even odd values. Suppose we are mentioning only even values, we have to mention first two even values like that. Okay, other is 1 to infinity means they consider both odd and even value. What's a constant? 8 by pi square is a constant. What's the remaining? 1 by n square into cos nx. What we are expecting, what we want to prove in the required result? They want pi square by 8 equals 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square, 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square, etc. Yeah, anyway, we already, suppose you expand this series, only odd values 1 by 3, 1 by 1 square, 1 by 3 square, 1 by 5 square. But I don't want cos value. Once you expand that, we get 1 by n square, 1 by 3 square, 1 by 5 square. I don't want cos nx. I want to convert cos nx must be equal to 1. Okay. Now, before moving to the next step, first you write, is the required Fourier series for the given function. Okay. Function over 0, minus pi, comma, plus pi. Okay. Now, you verify, you compare that. Now, I have to convert cos nx is equal to 1. Therefore, what value of x gives rise 1? 0. But what is our range? Minus pi to pi. Definitely, x 0 is included. Therefore, what we are going to do? Put x is equal to 0 in the above expression. We get what is f of 0 equals now 8 by pi square summation n ranging from only the odd values 1 to infinity 1 by n square because cos 0 is 1. Okay, fine. In the next step, I want to know what's the value of f of 0. Now, what's the value of f of 0? That's a very, very important. You know what is my f of x. What is my f of x? Again, I'm going to write what is my f of x. F of x is what actually? The given function is actually f of x is 1 plus 2 by pi into x in the range minus pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 0. 1 minus 2 by pi into x for 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi. Okay. Now, I want to find out what is my f of 0. F of 0 is nothing but put x is 0. Now, 0 is in the range what actually? 0 to pi. Therefore, if put x is 0, f of 0 is 1. Therefore, what we get actually? This value is 1. 1 is equal to 8 pi pi square of summation n ranging from 1, 3, etc. 1 by n square to infinity. That implies take this pi square by 8 is a common factor. We get pi square by 8 equals expand the summation 1 by 1 square plus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 5 square. This is our required result. You take pi square by 8 is cross multiplication automatically give rise our required result. Observe carefully before I'm going to wind up to this class. Again, I'm go back to the within 1 minute. I'm going to review the entire thing. First, try to verify the given function is an even or odd. Just replace everywhere x by minus x. Simplify that. Automatically, here we get even function. Which value 0? Bn is 0. Then we get a0 and an. While finding first, I taken instead of, first you find out carefully a0. Not necessary to take entire range minus pi to pi. You have to take only 0 to pi. What is the function have? 1 minus 2 by pi into x. Then based on that, you find out we get a0 is 0. While finding an, first I did mistake. I taken sign wrongly for overlook, that is cos nx. That's why I explain once again. And then simplify that, we get this value. I told in the flower bracket, one of the term is 1, one of the term is minus 1 to the power of n. In such cases, we are going to take, we have to take carefully, even cases, maybe odd cases are 0. Other case, we get common value. That's why here what happened, odd case, we get 2, even cases are 0. Now, you compare this to required result. In the required result, only required 1 by 3 square, 1 by 1 square, 1 by 5 square. I don't want cos nx. I can't convert 0. Suppose you convert 0, what happened? Enter summation 0. I have to convert that summation must be 1. summation, once you take, we have to convert cos is 0, entire summation is 0. Therefore, what we are going to do, cos nx I have to convert 1. Therefore, I am going to choose x is 0, no problem. 0 is in the given limit of the range. Once you substitute 0, simplify that, automatically we get required result of the given problem. This is a way to find out the solution of the Fourier series. Suppose the given function is a splitting function. Thank you very much for listening my talk, my lecture. I'll come and meet you in the next class, some more problem based on splitting functions. Okay, bye. See you. Take care.